Yeah.
Well, she sneaks around the world from Kiev to Carolina. She's a sticky-fingered filcher from Berlin down to Belize. She'll take you for a ride on a love boat to China. Tell me, where in the world is
Carmen Sandiego?
Good morning, everyone. Here we are just outside of Canyon City, Colorado. We've been on the road for a couple of days.
We passed our one-month mark.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. It's flown by.
Yeah.
Like it doesn't seem like we've been on the road that long, but then when you think about like
how long ago Patrick's Point was, Silver Falls,
or even Yellowstone, it's like, whoa, that was a long time ago. What? So we are officially headed west.
Yeah.
I'm making our return trip back. So after Mount Rushmore, we swung by Wind Cave and did a tour. So I thought that went pretty well.
That went really well. It was super super busy. So Wind Cave was the seventh national park in our nation, but it's also one of the least visited.
Just too bad.
Yeah, it's really, really beautiful. So that was fun, and I felt pretty lucky that we were able to get a spot down.
The tours are first come, first serve, which baffles me that
In this age of internet, we don't have online scheduling.
You show up and you hope you get a tour after you stand in line. Like it's bizarre.
Yeah.
But we got in with 17 people and a tour that all the kids could
participate in.
Yeah. And I think that's been one of the, not challenges, but challenge in a good way, is finding activities that everybody's interested in. You know, we got Holly and Seamus that are going into fourth grade wanting to do big kid stuff. And then you've got little kids that
need to be carried down into the cave.
Right, and you want to do it as a family. You know, sometimes you can divide and conquer and do big kid stuff and little kid stuff. But, you know, for the most part, it's like we want to do this all together. So finding ways that we can experience these things all together has been a challenge, but not like in a dread way, in a good way.
Right.
So then we went to Fort Collins. Stayed at a KOA there. KOAs aren't our favorite, but they certainly
serve their purpose.
And the kids think they're fantastic.
The kids love them. Absolutely love them. Because they have bikes and they have pool and splash pad.
And they have all these like cheesy things to do that the kids just think are great. And we're like, we just spent hundreds of miles, thousands of miles going to Mount Rushmore. And they're like, oh, but there's a bounce house.
Yeah.
So we did that, and then yesterday we drove from Fort Collins to Canyon City, and we did the Royal Gorge, and so it's like this huge suspension bridge.
Yeah, built in like 1929.
And it goes over like this really steep canyon over the Arkansas River.
Yeah.
So we got to ride like the gondola across, and so that was really fun. Mm-hmm. Got to see the rafters, like in boats that are rafting the Arkansas River.
We also saw the raptor show.
There was a raptor show, so we got to see some birds really close, so that was fun. It poured on us, so we sought shelter. But you know, I think it was a good way for everybody of all age groups to experience
the gorge
without having to hike all the way to the bottom.
Right.
And so that was fun.
Yep.
And now we're headed to Glenwood Canyon, so that's just north of Aspen on Highway 70, kind of the main road across the Rockies.
So we got a big hill climb today. We're right now at 6,600 feet, and the pass we're going over is right about 11,500. Yeah. So we're gonna charge up that hill and
It's weird that in a week we'll be home.
Yeah.
Because it's just seemed like this never-ending like journey. Like we joked at Silver Falls, like in a month we will still be camping, and here we are a month later.
And we're still camping,
but
the end is in sight.
Yeah, and that makes us kind of sad. So we're joking that we're just going to head back to Patrick's Point.
Right, if it's hot, let's just keep going to Patrick's Point.
If it's hot and smoky, we'll just stop and do our laundry, check on the trees, and come back when we have to.
Yeah.
So we've been gone this long. What's 2.5 more weeks?
Yep. It's been a really, really fun journey, experiencing our country, watching the road. I think one of my favorite part of road days is Holly will just be listening to her Percy Jackson book, and she'll just be watching the country go by. She'll say, "Dad, deer."
So she's listened to. So we're big Audible fans. Ethan was a big Audible fan.
Yep.
And so I think Holly's kind of embraced that, and So she's listened to the first five Percy Jacksons, and now I think she just finished like Greek Heroes or Greek Gods, which is like 11 hours or something.
Yeah.
So five, six, and then she had one before that. So I think she's listened to like seven Audible books, and I only buy them if they're longer than like 5 hours,
yeah,
because otherwise it's not worth the money.
Not worth the money.
So anyway, so she's been enjoying that. So I think that's been fun just because that's what Ethan was listening to last summer and reading. You know, I think having her listen to some of the same series that he listened to on Audible is helpful because they've already purchased. And then, you know, also knowing that this is the last series that Ethan listened to, or this is the last book that he read.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I think that's a good way for her
to connect.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So.
All right. On to Glenwood Canyon Springs. Glenwood Springs.
Glenwood Canyon.
See you next time.
I was buried beneath my shame. Who could carry that kind of weight? It was my turn till I met you. I was breathing but not alive. All my fears.